Store, America's number one furniture and mattress store.
When you think your safety's at risk, KXAN investigates for you.
It's Valentine's Day on Rachel Ray.
Oh, worst date ever.
So take a spin with this handsome devil.
I had a little gas issue.
Having decor dilemmas? Don't fight. Get it right.
You need to get you one of these.
Plus, our sweet Valentine's Day menu starts with cocktails.
Overstuff the shells, like really. Oh!
And creamy stuffed shells. And wraps up with a tip-top butterscotch pudding from Top Chef's Gail Simmons.
It's rich and delish, right?
I truly love coming to work today. We're starting off today with one of my absolute favorite guys, one of my favorite guests. He used to be the new kid on the block, but now he's been busy fighting crime for, I can't believe it, almost a decade now. Calm it down and keep it in your seat. Don't scare him. He's not even out here yet. Yeah, he's been on for 9 years on CBS's huge hit show, Blue Bloods. Please welcome back to our show, Donnie Wahlberg! I almost had to corral them. They were hopping out of their seats.
It happens.
They were riding a horse.
I don't know why, but it happens.
But isn't that lovely, right?
It's
that you
greatest.
Have that reaction after so many years and success in this in the business.
It's music to my ears.
Yeah.
Like, I know when we were young and we would go out on stage, the fans would scream and it was total hysteria and people would mock us. When you're a kid in a boy band and you have teenage girl fans, you know, everyone's like, ah, they just, but I've always.
Oh yeah, but an awful thing to have women screaming
exactly,
after you, right?
But when they're little girls,
yeah.
You know, people make fun of you and yada, yada, yada. But for me, I never disliked it. I love it to this day. When
it's
I go on
so
stage, because we still perform.
I know,
kids are still,
still perform.
When we go on stage and the fans scream, it's like, it's just my, it's
still
just, I can't even describe it.
The audience, the in-studio audience, before we started filming, I love coming to work today. He's one of my favorite peoples here, and he's actually part of a great couple. That's the most loving couple ever. I know, they're so sweet. So, I think this is adorable.
Oh.
I want you to explain this to the audience. It's the sweetest thing ever. I'm telling you, you're gonna need to brush your teeth.
Yeah, well, this is one of about 20 pillows that I have. Jenny gave me this massive box for Christmas, like our first Christmas after we were married. And so I was like, oh, this is gonna be something really great. But the box was really light. And I was like, I mean, it was huge, like your counter.
Yeah.
And I was like, I thought it was like a TV or something cool. And
it was, she could comfort my back.
It works. It works.
It's actually a quite nice pillow.
Yeah, well, I opened the box and it was pillow after pillow of her and I, of our kids, our dogs, you know, our kids' friends, like all just stuff that we could put everywhere to just remind us of the family and, you know, and a couple
and
of her and I.
Apart,
that's right.
You can hug the pillow.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
I know. What did I tell you people?
Right.
So do you have a Valentine tradition? Like John every year has to have carbonara and instead of flowers, I make him a bouquet of 12 salami.
Yeah. I'm going to tell my Valentine tradition and I'm going to trust that none of my fans will stalk this place. And I say that affectionately,
yes.
You know, stalking is okay with my fans. I know it's a dangerous thing, but our fans say it affectionately. We go to a place in New York, because we when we started dating, we were both working in New York. Right. We moved in together in New York. We go to a little place called Glenmere Mansion.
Oh, yeah.
And it's a little 16-room hotel, and it's so quiet and beautiful. It is the most magical place on earth. And that's because we're both always working in the city, so hop in a car, we drive up 45 minutes away. We actually featured it in an episode of Donnie Loves Jenny before. It's the most wonderful place in the world, and it's important for couples to, you know, you're in this for the long haul, and so many times as couples, work becomes more important, and when you have kids, my kids are number one. The couple has to be number one in any relationship, you know,
sometimes I think we even forget you are a couple.
That's right,
Just work.
That's right.
And like, make dinner, go to sleep.
That's
work, you know what I mean? You just forget that it's supposed to be fun.
Yeah, and you have to find a way to take those little moments, even if it's like drive in the car around the corner in a little quiet area and make out with your like husband or wife.
No, seriously.
Yeah, it's true. It's like, that's how you fell in love. You did that stuff when you were courting and fell in love, and then you stopped doing it because you got to work and pay the bills. No, you got to keep doing it.
Exactly.
And you show your kids what love looks like by making the relationship
That's
work.
What I was going to ask you next. Because the kids now, I mean, teenagers up to what, mid-20s?
I have a 25-year-old son, a 17-year-old son, and Jenny's son.
And Evan
now, my stepson, Evan, is 16.
16,
that's my son, Elijah.
Now, I don't know about you guys.
Look at that handsome boy. These are some good-looking
kids. Good-looking children.
Sheesh.
Now, my mom and I never specifically had a talk about dating or even about sex, but my mother was very vocal about every boy that I ever brought around, right? Do you ever give advice to your own sons, or is it just too weird?
Well,
or do they go to Jenny?
It's perfect. You nailed it. It's perfect because Evan and Jenny have been together, obviously, all of his life, and Elijah and I have been together all of his life. And when Jenny and I got together, you know, in the ways that Elijah and I don't quite connect, I connect with Evan. And the same with
That's
Evan and,
so
and Elijah and Jenny. So, yes.
You make a patchwork quilt.
Elijah talks to Jenny about anything that ain't sports.
Yeah.
If it's sports, he talks to me, and anything else, he goes to Jenny. And with Evan, you know, he'll talk to me about a bully in school, how do I handle this, and you know, so it's just been a perfect relationship, and we both are parenting both kids, and it's just amazing.
I am so freaked out that Blue Bloods has been on for 9 years, almost a decade, but we've talked about this so many times, but there's so much to love about this show.
Mm-hmm.
It is really well written. It is taut, but it's also human.
Yeah, it's authentic. You know, the relationship of the family is really the core of the show for so many viewers, and the relationship is real. You know, we get along like a real family. You know, Bridget will call me over to her dressing room and say, can I talk to you? I'm going through some stuff for my son. You know, we just talk about real stuff, and it's just that bond, I think, really resonates throughout the show.
And it gives it the integrity.
It really does.
Because
it really
people
does.
Can see that. When you're being intimate, people understand that, whether it's scripted or unscripted, you get that feeling. Don't you think? Even in a scripted show, you can feel if something's legit.
Yeah, and I know who Dad is. You know, I can be on tour, because sometimes my tours and my other jobs, like Wahlburgers and different things, overlap, Blue Bloods.
Flop over each other.
Yeah, so I'm like flying in and out, and I'll get off a private jet from a concert. That's the only way I can get to Blue Bloods on time to work the next morning. I run into the set, you know, with confetti in my hair from last night's concert. But when I sit at that dinner table, as big and important as I might feel from my concert the night before,
Dad
is in charge.
More important.
Dad is in charge.
That's how you roll.
That's right. Dad being Tom Selleck.
Of course. Dad being Tom Selleck, another dear friend of our show for many, many, many years. And the greatest, I know, still, greatest mustache too on the planet, like ever.
It's a powerful mustache.
It really is, isn't it?
Powerful.
Him and Sam Elliott, I'm like, oh, God, that rolls deep, man.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Anyway, I'm having so much fun at work today, it's almost illegal. All right, let's watch a clip, and then we're going to go over and literally play spin the bottle, like hilarious.
All right.
We set up this silly thing because it's Valentine's Day. Watch this.
How's the store?
He's banged up pretty bad, but he's not likely because of you.
Good.
How about you? How are you holding up?
It's not my first shooting, you know.
The kid was young, that's all.
What does it matter? He tried to stab me. I shot him. That's that.
Nobody's saying it's not a clean shooting. The investigator already said it looks justified.
Okay, well, then what are we talking about?
Nothing. Just get some sleep, all right?
I will. I'm scared.
Played spin the bottle when I was a kid. Did you ever play legit spin the bottle? You know, like
I
the
did.
And all that stuff. You
I did. I did. Yep. Spin the bottle. Truth
How'd
or dare.
How'd it go?
A lot of kissing. A lot of kissing.
This is not kissing. At least I hope not. I don't know what our staff put up here, but basically, spin it not too fast. We're only an hour-long show. It lands on truth or dare. You read the card, you do it, or you don't do it. Whatever.
Okay.
I'm not going to trap you in the building.
Listen, I've gotten in trouble on this show. I had to impersonate my wife
That's
once.
That's true.
I had
yes.
to and she did not like the impersonation. I think I picked my nose and went. And I breakdanced. I ruptured.
You ruptured a
section of my spleen,
herniated.
Actually. Yeah. All right, ready?
All right.
Alright, yep.
Let's see.
What nicknames do you and Jenny have for each other? Okay. They've evolved, but I'll give you a few quick
they've
ones.
They've evolved?
When we started dating, she called me Chomp.
Chomp, that's warm.
No, yeah. Well, her favorite movie is Airplane, and Mrs. Barbara Billingsley
right.
calls the guy a chump, and so she we laughed about it, and she called me Chomp. And I called her Mama Bum Bum. Because she has a really
she's
nice,
got
bum,
a nice
bum.
Bum bum.
But it's evolved, and now I'm Mr. and she's Lady.
Aww, that's what we call it. Mr. and Lady.
Mr.
That's
and Lady.
Disney friendly.
Yeah.
All right, give me another spin. Oh.
You can ask.
Aw, that's sweet.
Without saying a word, look into the
You're
camera.
You're saying a lot of words.
Oh, shoot, you're right. I'm yeah. okay. I love you, Jenny.
Aww. It's a Valentine message.
Okay. Yo, if that was the
really?
Dollar, if
really?
That was the dollar on the
really?
Price is Right,
really?
Do you know how rich I would be right now?
Spin it again. My God, will you stop?
I think it's a gravitational
thing. This
thing
is rigged.
All right.
Oh, okay, phew. My God. Oh, worst date ever.
Oh,
come on, really reach back there. Did you ever have a really bad date?
I'm a good date,
yeah.
but things happen. No, things happen that you can't control.
Right. So, worst date ever.
I had a little gas issue. And I couldn't really control it. And let's just say I used to eat a lot more salt back then. And there's a sulfury smell that comes when you eat a lot of salt.
I'm vividly aware, like that over hard-boiled egg with salt smell.
Yeah. Right. I worked out with Jenny, though.
Yeah,
I started dating
out.
Her. She farts more than me. It was
That's
perfect.
Right. She's more gaseous than you.
Exactly.
How are things with the Wahlburger? How goes the burger empire, the family burger business?
You know what? Because we're famous, people don't think of it as a small business, but we really are. We're growing, and it's doing really well. But, you know, we're at our 30th location.
Wow.
Yeah, we've had a few tough ones, and had some growing pains, but you know we're learning. Like any small business owner, we're learning and trying to get the right formula. So for every 10 that worked, is one that might not. But it's all part of the process of learning and building
a
true business.
Number.
Yeah, yeah.
Give me the pillow. I want to see.
Aww.
We miss you, Jenny. We're hugging you. Thank you, Donnie.
I love you.
Make sure to check out Blue Bloods. CBS, of course, Fridays at 10 p.m. Don't go anywhere. We literally have some sweets for you guys that you could make tonight or this weekend with Top Chef Judge, a delightful woman, one of our favorites. Gail Simmons is in the kitchen right after this. Tomorrow,
I live on the fifth floor, and we don't have an elevator.
How sweet is your home sweet home? Three viewers in three different cities show off how they get the most out of $1,400 a month.
It allows you to.
It's so